Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this past week we had a bit of a surprise release with iOS 16.1.2. We also had iOS 16.2 Beta 4 with more features, changes, and updates that have been found since the initial iOS 16.2 Beta 4 is out video. So we'll talk about that. We'll also talk about the overall experience based off the YouTube community poll and more, where there's 196 comments and over 9,700 votes, almost 10,000 votes at the time of this video. So I've read all of these comments to give us a general understanding and the overall experience of what it's like using either one of those. So we'll talk about battery life and more a little bit later. Now, the first thing is iOS 16.1.2 was released this week with security updates. The odd thing is Apple hasn't updated the security website yet. So if we refresh the website here and scroll down, you'll see that it says that it released iOS 16.1.2, but it says details available soon. Typically, after a few hours of release, Apple will actually update this. So far, it's been a few days and we haven't seen this updated. So what exactly is in this update as far as security updates? Maybe they're kind of not wanting to tell anyone until iOS 16.2 is out, or hopefully they'll update this soon so we know exactly what they fixed. So that's a bit odd. However, we do know that iOS 16.1.2 had fixes for the overall connectivity and carrier updates, and it seems like, according to most people, that the overall connectivity is improved this time around. Not 100% for everyone, but I've had a lot of positive reports saying that it's much better, so I thought I'd just mention that. Now, with iOS 16.2 being almost here, probably a couple weeks away, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, there's some new features in this update. The major one, which I wanted just to refresh before we talk about the brand new features that have been found since, is Freeform, the collaboration app. This is something that was promised with iOS 16 and is still not out. So we'll see that with the release of iOS 16.2, as well as the always-on display changes, where you can change the wallpaper to turn off. So in the display settings, if you have an iPhone 14 Pro or Pro Max, and you go to display and brightness, and then down to always on display, you can turn off the wallpaper and just make it an all black display. So far, I haven't seen an improvement really with battery life with that in my experience, but it's there if you just want it to be off altogether. So that's something worth noting. And then of course, 5G in India, that will be coming with this update, but there's even more to talk about. And with beta 4, we had notification updates, quite a few of them actually. So if we scroll down, you'll see notifications. And one of the things is you can see some of your older notifications now without swiping up. So that's been changed. The overall animation has changed a little bit, and I mentioned that before. However, they made some major changes, as this is a little bit buggy. Also, we're not exactly sure when, but based off of maybe beta 2, beta 3, you can't swipe multiple notifications away at once using multiple fingers anymore for some reason. It doesn't seem to work. So that's something they've changed. Hopefully they changed that part back, but at least they've given us more notifications on the screen at once. So that's a great sign. And again, on this one here, you can see there's even more notifications. So if I try to swipe those off, only one at a time is allowed for some reason. So I'm not really sure why that is. Now, when you're using Shazam from the control center, this is something that's been updated. If you have a phone that's not an iPhone 14 Pro or Pro Max, they actually have a new icon here. So if I press the Shazam button, swipe home, and give it a second, you'll see there's a microphone icon that appears in the upper left. It shows in the dynamic island on the iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max, but that was actually there before with previous updates. So again, if we go to the Shazam thing here, or Shazam button here rather, you'll see the microphone shows up in the dynamic island, but that was there with previous updates. Also, when you're using the dynamic island this time around, I mentioned a little bit about this before. If maybe we play a song, let me turn this down. Maybe we'll just go in and we'll play a song here, swipe up. It's in the dynamic island. You'll see that the outline on a black background is very faint compared to what we had before with beta 3 or earlier. So we'll do the same thing on the previous one. Swipe home. And you can see the outline is a little more prominent on the iPhone 14 Pro with beta 3, as opposed to the Pro Max on beta 4. So that's something that's changed. I don't know that I like it. I kind of like the more prominent dynamic island outline. However, I hope maybe they give us the option for that in the future. That's something I would definitely welcome and like to see with this update, but maybe we'll see that with the release candidate. Now, if you have an M1 or M2 based iPad and you plug in an external display on iPadOS 16.2 beta 4, we'll wait for it to connect. Give it just a moment. There's an odd change that is sort of a new behavior, but seems like a bug. So if we press play, maybe on this song here, and then we tap on this option to maybe AirPlay this to some HomePods, you'll now get a message that says AirPlay is unavailable while an external display is connected. Now, maybe this was causing an issue in the past, so they added this. I saw this in the code that they added it, and then now it's updated, and it's actually a feature, not an error. So it's something they've changed that maybe was causing enough problems where you can't AirPlay. But it's a bit disappointing, as maybe if you're using HomePods in stereo as your speakers for your monitor, it doesn't look like that will work when an external display is connected. So this is reproducible on all of the external display connected iPads. It's a very strange behavior, and it happens over and over now. Hopefully it's fixed with the RC or the final release. Now, also back with the always on display, you can see here that it's actually been updated as far as the overall wording, where before it would say when, and now it actually says WHEN like it should. And my friend Steve Mosier posted this some time ago. So as you can see here, this is what it looked like before. So they fixed that typo. They've had a couple typos this year in different updates as well. Now, also in the What's New video, if we go to accessibility, you can see there's new icons for Apple Watch mirroring and control nearby devices. So that's something I mentioned before that I just thought I'd point out again. It's a small change, but they have changed some icons throughout, as you can see here with beta 3 on the left, beta 4 on the right. So just some new icons there. There's also some updates to the Apple Watch, but I don't think they've enabled a few things here as far as what we can see, as there's a lot more in the code. So for example, group messaging options to allow group messaging. We're not sure if this is a feature or a settings change they're going to have in the future. I couldn't find it anywhere. And there's a lot talking about being able to undelete junk from messages as well. So there could be some new message updates with the final release or release candidate, but we haven't seen those yet. I looked all throughout settings, but hopefully this isn't something that's similar to the AirDrop thing we saw that was in China. So where they would actually change this and stop you from actually keeping it on everyone all the time. So that's something that might roll out to everyone, but under AirDrop, you'll see that we have everyone. In China, it's everyone for 10 minutes. In the code of this version with beta 4, it looks like group messaging has some similar options. We just haven't seen it enabled yet. So if you're overseas and you actually see a difference with messaging for group messaging, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. But there's definitely some changes there also regarding junk. Now, there's two things I wanted to mention before we talk about bugs that have been fixed and bugs that are remaining. And the first one has to do with Apple's upcoming AR/VR headset. Now, this is something that is in the supply chain and people are hearing, and we knew from the code was going to have a new OS called Reality OS. However, recent information says it's now been renamed to XR OS or 10R OS, which is a bit odd since that's a phone, the iPhone 10R. So hopefully this is just sort of a placeholder, or maybe they'll change it in the future. We don't really know, but it's just something that I thought was odd since we saw it in the code as Reality OS for so long. Also, emergency SOS on the latest iPhone 14s appeared to have helped someone in Alaska. So whether or not they were stranded, they were in Alaska without signal on a snowmobile, they were actually rescued with emergency SOS. So it's great to see that that's actually worked, at least for the first time that we know of. Hopefully it's helped some other people as well that maybe needed a little additional help and didn't have a signal. So it's great that that's working already for some people. Now, as far as things that have been fixed, well, people have said that they've fixed the Apple Watch sync issue. So if you had notifications coming in really late or not showing up at all on an Apple Watch, apparently it's fixed that issue overall. So that's great news. Also, many people have said the rotation bug is fixed. So if we go into YouTube, and within YouTube, if I play one of my videos and rotate the screen, it's not super smooth for me, but it seems to be better for a lot of people. So for some people that's fixed. It's not fixed for me yet, but let me know in the comments below if it's working better for you. Now, as far as bugs, well, the first thing you may have already noticed is if we go into the control center at the top, you'll see system services. This is constantly there with beta 4. So you, of course, could turn this off. You could turn off system services altogether and just disable it. But under privacy and system services, location is constantly being used with beta 4. It doesn't really seem to be affecting battery performance too much, but it's just constantly there. So I assume that's a bug at this point, but we don't know for sure. Also, the swipe home bug is still there. So when you swipe home, let's see if we hit play again. Swipe home, you'll see it lags a little bit when it goes to the dynamic island. Why this is happening is hard to say. It's laggy all over the place, not just that, but going into different websites, swiping to different apps, sometimes is just super laggy going between apps. This sort of animation is something that Apple's been great at for years, but for some reason continues to be a problem on this update and previous iOS 16 updates with the 14 Pro and Pro Max for some reason. Now, another odd bug some people are reporting with the original AirPods Pro, if maybe we connect one and go into our battery, some people are saying that the case is showing zero. Here it's showing the correct charge for me, but when music is playing, sometimes they say this shows incorrectly. So let's go ahead and hit play, see if it jumps over to my AirPods here. And it looks like it's playing. And you'll see the case is showing correctly. But for some people, it's not. So thought it's worth mentioning as it's a little odd for some people. Also, something else worth mentioning is in the notifications, while they're updating this quite a bit, sometimes they're very laggy. Like I mentioned earlier, you can see that behavior there. And as I scroll down, the music player sort of disappears. So this is some odd behavior we're seeing. You're swiping down. Sometimes people see it disappear altogether, and it doesn't seem like it should be behaving like that. So all of these things need to be reported in the feedback app and seem to be a problem still. Also, many people have asked me about the camera and if the photos are any different now. So let's go ahead and take a screenshot of what this looks like here. And then we'll go ahead and take the photo itself and see how it processes it. And as you can see here, let me go ahead and save that to photos. As you can see with the photos, it looks okay, but I'm not sure it looks the same as what we had. Typically, the photos have been overprocessed and darkened. And let me know if it's better for you. I mentioned this in some other videos as well, and we've been hoping that Apple's going to fix it. It just seems to be the post-processing of it. Also, some people are still mentioning they have a storage bug. I really haven't seen too much of an issue with this, so we'll let this load. Give it just a moment here. Now, storage finished loading, and as you can see, I have 130 gigabytes used of 256. A good portion of that is system data, but that's okay as it's using that as cache, and I don't need that storage for anything. And you'll see iOS is taking up 9.58 gigabytes. That's pretty typical. Anytime you install an update, it overwrites the old one or deletes the old files. And you can see system data is 35 gigabytes. And that's not really an issue unless I need the storage for apps or something. So since there's additional storage available, we have plenty of storage, and it's just going to use that as cache data. So no issues there. As far as overall battery life, well, battery life seems to be pretty good for most people at this point. Initially, iOS 16.1.2 had quite a few complaints, but after a few days of processing, most people have said it improved. So depending on when you installed it, it needed to finish processing things in the background. And once it did that, most people say it's about the same as iOS 16.1.1 or maybe a little bit better. And I asked someone in my Telegram group to actually send over their battery life so we could take a look. And as you can see, iPhone 11, 82% battery health. Thanks for sending that over. And you'll see here 6 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen off time. That's pretty great considering 82% battery health and it's an iPhone 11. So that's pretty good battery life. And in general, I'm hearing good things. I wouldn't expect major changes though, as it's a minor update. As far as iOS 16.2 beta 4, well, I'm running that full time on this device and my battery health is still 100% since it's a newer phone. And over the last 10 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 40 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 56 minutes of screen idle time, used about 45% of my battery. It can improve. It seems to be okay, maybe a little bit better than before with 5 hours the previous day and still not using 75%. So I think it's improving. As we get closer to the final release, I think we'll see a bigger improvement. As far as overall performance seems good, except for that swiping home bug that I showed you over and over and the lag. If those things were gone, it would feel super smooth. ProMotion is nice and fast. It hasn't slowed down over the past couple of days. Going into different apps is nice and fast. Wi-Fi seems to be good for me, as well as cellular data in general. Some people said they noticed slower data rates as far as the overall update, but that could depend on your carrier, how close you are to the tower and more. So it would have to be the exact same scenario at the same time of day and same time of usage, and how many phones are using it makes a difference as well. So it's really hard to measure that. As far as the heat of the device, well, I've run Geekbench on this not too long ago just to check that out, and we'll look at that in a moment. it seems to be nice and cool still. So I really have never paid attention much to heat, even charging or anything else. If you use MagSafe, it monitors that for you with temperature sensors and regulates the overall voltage. So it's really not something recurrent. I really wouldn't worry about that. It's not something that I typically pay too much attention to. If you have a case on it that completely seals the phone, consider removing that if you're fast charging. Now, as far as the next release, I would expect it to be the release candidate. As we're getting closer to the middle of December, that's typically when Apple releases this. So that means next week, I would expect the release candidate. Last year, we had iOS 15.2 beta 4 on December 2nd, and then we had the release candidate on December 7th. I would expect the release candidate probably as soon as Tuesday. It could change, of course, but based off of what we've had, I would think Tuesday makes a lot of sense. We could have it Thursday with a final release on Monday. I would expect Monday the 12th to have the final release of iOS 16.2 to the public. So that seems to make the most sense. They could push this out with a beta 5 and then an RC, but I think iOS 16.2 RC or release candidate will be early next week. And again, a final release the following week with nothing in between until January. Typically, we won't see the next version of betas until probably mid-January or the second week of January at least. Apple takes a break for Christmas and New Year's and other holidays, and that's when we'll see those updates later on as people are taking a break. So that makes a lot of sense. We'll see 16.3 then with maybe some new features after that. Now let's take a look at some of your comments. So I have a few I've just chosen randomly here, depending on the version they were on. You'll see Sean says, seems to be smoother, way less animation stutter when swiping home. Battery life seems really good. iOS 16.2.1 on a 14 Pro Max. Now typically if someone asks me to read their comment, I don't always do that, but there's some good points that are mentioned here. And as you can see, iOS 16.1.2 on iPhone 13, battery life is better than 16.1.1, but not as good as iOS 15. Apple degraded the camera quality. I can now see the switching of the camera lenses with blurry effect while recording video, and most pictures are overexposed, etc. The phone heats a lot less compared to 16.1.1, but still it heats. And that's typically normal if you're doing intensive tasks anyway. Some notifications don't go even after I slide them away. They're stuck with a huge clear all button. Wi-Fi doesn't connect automatically. I have to manually connect most of the time. I haven't seen that myself. Messages fail to be sent so many times. Most annoying issue of all is that data is taking 57 gigabytes of space and Safari is not working properly many times. It won't load the website and gets stuck midway. I'm facing these issues from iOS 16.0.3 and it's getting worse with some improvements. Jeremy DeBose says iOS 16.2 beta 4 on a 14 Pro Max, performance and battery life, etc. have all been solid so far. Taking 48 megapixel pictures also seems to not take quite as long to process now too. And 6 people gave it a thumbs up, hopefully thinking the exact same thing or having the same experience. Kwame says iOS 16.1.2 on an iPhone 13 Pro Max, battery health at 97%. Battery performance is quite the same as iOS 16.1.1, but overall performance has been improved. Normally charge my phone from 22 to 89% each day, and I'm getting 6 to 7 hours between that period. Shivam Krishan Agrawal says this version solved Apple Watch not syncing messages. And so that's everything with iOS 16.1.2, which was a bit unexpected, and iOS 16.2 beta 4. Maybe there's a few more changes here and there, but that's everything I was able to find. But if you found something, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. I think iOS 16.2 will be a great update with over 20 different changes, so I'm looking forward to that. Let me know if you've found anything else in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.